Hi, I'm Ashley, and welcome to Order of Operations. Did you know that when solving longer math problems, you don't always work from left to right? In this video, we're going to learn the proper order to use to end up at the correct answer. Are you ready? Let's go! This is the order that we must follow. Look here at the top, I have the letters P, E, M, D, A, S. These letters represent the operations that we must do and the order that they must be done in. So P is for parentheses, E for exponents, M for multiplication, D division, A is addition, and S is subtraction. I like to say PEMDAS. That helps me to remember the order. Other people like to use the sentence, please excuse my dear Aunt Sally. So notice the first letter of each of these words is also the first letter of each of the operations. So please for parentheses, excuse is exponents, my is multiplication, dear is division, aunt is addition, and Sally is subtraction. Now, one important thing to know is that my dear, multiplication and division, are interchangeable in their order, and then addition and subtraction are interchangeable with each other in their order. Okay, so if you do not yet have a thorough understanding of each of these operations and how to use them with both positive and negative numbers or with decimals, it's important that you make sure you understand those things first before continuing with order of operations. Okay, let's get started. Okay, here is our first problem. You see, I put PEMDAS here in the top left to help us remember the order. You might want to do that as well. Write that down on your paper. All right, this problem is a little bit simpler. It does not include parentheses or exponents, so I'm just going to mark that out here. We're only dealing with these last ones. Okay, so let's look at this over here. Negative 9 plus 11 times negative 5. Remember, we are not moving from left to right. We're going in order based on the operation. Okay, so first operation we need to find is multiplication. Okay, that over here is going to be 11 times negative 5. The answer to 11 times negative 5 is negative 55. Okay, now I'm going to bring down the negative 9 that I have over here, and the addition sign. Now, this is all I have left is addition. Okay, negative 9 plus a negative 55 is equal to negative 64. This is our final answer. All right, now here's our next one. This one is a little bit more challenging. We do have parentheses and an exponent in this problem. So first things first, P for parentheses. That means we have to do everything that is inside of the parentheses before we can do anything else. So here we have a set of parentheses. Within that, we have 4 times 15 divided by a negative 2. All right, so within the parentheses, we also have to follow our order of operations, but both multiplication and division are interchangeable, so that means from there we will move from left to right. So 4 times 15 gives us 60. I'm going to then divide by negative 2. Now I am still within my parentheses, so I'm going to continue. 60 divided by negative 2 is equal to negative 30. Okay, now I am finished with what is inside of the parentheses. I'll keep that there just so you can see it. All right, now I'm going to bring down this 9 squared that we have and the addition sign. Okay, so do I do negative 30 plus 9? No, not yet, because remember, our order, our second thing is exponent. So 9 squared, we need to solve that, is 81. It's like saying 9 times 9 is 81. Bring down my negative 30 and the addition sign. You can continue bringing down the parentheses here if you want, but it doesn't matter since that's all that's inside. So now I have 30 plus 81. That's all that's left. And that gives us a final answer of 51. I always like to box my final answer, especially on long problems like this where there's a lot of work. It helps to keep it clear for me and clear for the teacher to see where my final answer is. It's also good if you continuously keep your work underneath the operation you just did. It will help your instructor to see the steps you took, and if you made a mistake, he or she can go back and look at the work that you just did and find exactly where you made a mistake and help you to correct it. And that's it. We just practiced order of operations. Remember, please excuse my dear Aunt Sally, or PEMDAS can help you to remember that order that you must go in. Please go back and watch this again to help you remember those steps, and then practice what you've learned with our fun online games and quizzes. And remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.